both the White House and with Senate Republicans. And to that end, and they are offering, it appears, different things. And I know this is certainly a moving target, these negotiations. But as you're dealing with the White House, I wonder, you met last night with Mark Meadows, the chief of staff, yeah. and you certainly knew him previously in his capacity as a member of Congress. Yeah. Do you trust him in these negotiations?
What I trust is our meeting the needs of the American people. When they come to terms with that, we'll have an agreement. I think we will have an agreement at some point because it's very necessary. It's very necessary for have a strategic plan on testing so that we can open our economy and make our community safer.
But do you trust him as a negotiator, Speaker?
Well, that's not an appropriate question for you to ask. I will say this.
Well,
whatever
how is
he
that
said
not,
about
how is
making
that not appropriate
four
if you're negotiating
that,
with him, hmm? You must be able to trust him in order to negotiate.
Why would I
with
have to trust him? He's
way,
a representative
right?
of the president of President Trump. That's who the president sent. The president Trump trusts him. That's the relationship. It's a question of where we can pragmatically come to terms on an agreement. The president trusts him. He sends him in the room. We assume he's speaking for the president, although they all have to go running back and ask the president this, that, or the other thing. But that's okay. That's the way it is. I'm not complaining about that. What I am complaining about is they don't have shared values, and they want to waive some they have not. Your also the inference that I'm drawing from what you're saying is these offers he's making, they don't exist. So let me just say this. $600 is a number that families need to succeed. It has something that has kept many people out of poverty. It is a number that is also something that makes sense in most of the country. They're trying to say these people are just taking that money and staying home instead of going to work. That is disrespectful.
But
and
you want
we
that
have
money
the data
attached
to prove
a more comprehensive
that it isn't
proposal,
even true.
Right?
I'm sorry?
You want that money attached to a more comprehensive proposal, not just as a standalone.
We do, and we have it in a proposal
okay.
that honors our heroes, our men and women who are in healthcare, whatever, teachers, transportation, sanitation, first responders, food suppliers. They work for state and local government. We're honoring our heroes. We have no right to honor them if we're not willing to pay them. Secondly, we are saying open our economy by having testing, tracing, treatment, separation, masks, sanitation, and the rest. We don't have a virus until we do. We have the tools that can contain the spread of this. Third, we want money in the pockets of the American people. We don't want to say, and I'll leave you with this thought, we're not saying to the American people, we have a terrible virus. It is spiking. It is spreading. And we're going to give you a cut in the benefit that you have received attached to this virus. We're going
I
to
do
give
want
you
to
a
ask
cut
you,
in the benefit. That's what they're offering to the American people. We cannot let that happen.
I want to ask you because obviously, look, Congress can't do its job unless it stays well enough. And that really hit home this week when Louie Gohmert tested positive for COVID, someone who has not worn a mask. You this week decided to make masks mandatory on the floor. There has not been widespread available testing on Capitol Hill. I know that you say that is the purview of the physician's office there in the Capitol. But look, with all due respect, you are the speaker. And for folks familiar with your leadership style, I think the expectation is that if you wanted that testing and that were a priority for you, it's something that would happen. Is that something that is going to happen? And also, do you wish that on the floor you had made masks mandatory previously?
Well, what's important to know about masks, we ask people to wear masks and in committees and all the rest. But what's important about the mask requirement is enforcement. And until we could get the go-ahead that we would have enforcement from the Capitol Police, it could only be a recommendation. But now we have their approval to say it's a requirement and that people will not be allowed onto the floor of the House if they don't have a mask on. And if they don't have a mask, we have one for them. And if they take their mask off, they'll be asked to leave. So it's not just about what I want. It's about what is enforceable. Secondly, in terms of the physician, this may sound strange to you, I think. This is about science. It's what the doctors tell us that we need to do. It's not what I say so that I can come on a show and say I called for testing. It's not just about testing members of Congress. We have the support staff. There are 20,000 people who make the Congress function. Now, they're not all there now because of the coronavirus, but thousands are. So it's not just about us, and why should we take precedence over people out there, especially in the minority communities, who don't have access to testing? And that takes us back to science. And what we want the president to do is to have the Defense Production Act produce the equipment that enables us to have enough tests for everybody who wants to be tested to be tested, and for the machinery, the equipment, to be able to get a result from the test in a shorter period of time than 1 week, and have the tracing, therefore, that would go with that. So this is about science. It's not about, I mean, you're the speaker, you can make it happen. We have to act in a way that is scientific. And somehow or other, the Republicans have an aversion to science and to governance. But we have to respect the role of both in all of this. These are the tools to stop the spread of the virus, which is moving like a freight train. And it's about lives, it's about livelihood, and it's about the life of our democracy, when we have to have, we don't want people to have to make a choice between voting or jeopardizing their health because of the coronavirus. This is all very important, and we will get our job done. We have had four bipartisan bills before. The need is only greater now because of the increased number of those infected. And sadly, today on the floor, we had a motion of a moment of silence for 150,000 Americans who've died of the coronavirus. Very sad. We mourned John Lewis, but as he said to me before he left us, this is one life we're mourning. 150,000 Americans have died of the coronavirus and more to come. Let's say have a lot of sympathy for those people and prevent more of that from happening. We can do it. We have the tools. We have to look to science for the best possible route. That's what we intend to do.